Welcome back to Fun with Fusion 360. In this video, we will reduce the weight of our component by removing the areas where the moment or force is not acting. With the help of shape optimization simulation analysis, I will be using the same gear which was used for the static stress simulation in my previous video. So let's get started. We'll go to tools, we'll go to add-ins, we'll go to script and add-ins. We'll double click on spur gear. We'll select the whole diameter as 40. Okay. Let's go to the simulation. We are creating the shape optimization simulation study. We'll do create study. First we'll go to simplify. We'll create a sketch on the gear. Create a circle. Let's consider only 1/4 of the gear. And we can do a circular pattern later on. I'll say finish sketch. Extrude. Extrude everything except for the hub. Distance will be one side, extent will be two object. If we do this object and we'll say join. Okay. Now we'll go to modify, we'll go to split, we'll go to split body. We'll select this body, splitting tool as any one of the sides. I'll say okay. Again go to the top view. Go to modify, go to split. We don't need only 1/4 of the body, we'll go to split body. We'll split this body. The splitting tool will be this one. We'll say okay. So now we've got 3 bodies. We'll go to model components, bodies. You'll see that we have 3 bodies. Body 1. We don't need body 1 and body 2. So we will remove them. We need only body 3. And we'll say finish, simplify. We've done with simplify, we'll go to materials. We'll go to study materials. Here I'll take cast iron. Okay, done with material. We'll add constraints. This face is fully fixed and we'll add a load. We'll add a moment at this face, let's say 10,000 Nm. Okay, now we'll go to shape optimization. Go to preserve region. Let's preserve this part of the body. I'll say OK. Again, shape optimization, criteria, target mass. Like we want to reduce the mass, right? So I want to reduce at least 40% of the mass. That's what we've got to mention here. We'll say OK. Done with this. So we'll create the mesh now. Done with the mesh shape. It's telling that shape optimization target is missing, so we'll go to shape optimization target. We'll select this body and we'll say okay. So now you see our pre-check is done and we can solve it. So we'll press solve. I'll be solving it on the cloud. We can't solve a shape analysis locally, we can only do it on the cloud. We'll name it as gear simulation 2.
A few moments later.
So our results is done. Our results is calculated. You can see how the load path is on the 1/4 section of the gear. Let's animate and see. This is the load distribution. The red parts tell the stress is more. The blue parts tell us the stress is less in that particular region. So what we'll do is we'll clear out these 3 regions. They're not required because there's no stress acting there. Say okay. So we'll go to promote, add mesh object to design workspace. Okay, now we've bought it here. We want to create a drawing so that we can extrude the parts which we don't want. So we'll go to per gear and opacity, I'll put it as 10%. That we can just see it slightly. We need to create a mesh drawing. For that we need to make an offset plane. Go to the front view, take this plane little upwards, I'll say okay. Then I'll go to create. I'll go to create mesh section sketch. This is the mesh body. The mesh plane will be the construction plane. I'll say okay. We got the construction sketch. We will close all the bodies. We just want the sketch for now. Top view. So we'll say create sketch. In the sketch. So I'll be making a circle. First one near these both regions. And the second one near the gear teeth. I'll make a line here to here. Now let me create a construction line, but it should be 45 degrees so that we can mirror it later on. So that's 45 degrees. Now we don't need any construction line. We go to line again. We draw a line here. We go to the parallel constraint. Make sure that line is parallel to this line. Go to line again. We make a line from here to here and then here. And now again we'll add the parallel constraints so that this is parallel to this and this is parallel to this. So then let's go to a mirror. I'll be mirroring this part, this line as well as this line. The mirror line will be the construction line. That's it. Now after this is done, we need to extrude all this. So we'll say finish sketch. We'll hide our square for now. We'll go to extrude. We'll select this region, as well as this region. So these are the places where there was no force acting. Now I'll bring back the square. I'll say extend to all, direction symmetric. Operation cut. Extend to all. Okay. We'll say okay. See, our hole is done. So we'll go back to this thing, opacity. We make it as 100%. Go to your top view. You can see that the unwanted parts, okay, where the stress distribution was less, we've deleted those parts. So we'll go to create. We'll go to pattern. We'll go to circle. Oh no, not pattern on path. We'll create. We'll get pattern, circular pattern. It will be features. Objects will be the extrude one. The axis will be the blue line. We want quantity 4. We'll say okay. Again, we'll go to the top view. So let's make some fillets. I'll select the fillet option. We need rule fillets. All edges, faces of features. We'll select the circular. Wait, let's select the extrude first. And the circular rule fillet, all edges. Let's hide our sketches, circular pattern as well as extrude both. I would say a 5 mm, give how much ever you want. Let's see how this turns out. Okay, now we've filleted it. After filleting, we'll again go to the simulation workspace. You'll see that we've come back again to the part where our previous model was at. Here we'll say finish results. We'll go to study. We'll create a new study, a new static stress study. Create study. We'll go to simplify. New simulation model. We want our new model, which we made just now. So we'll do the same procedure. We'll create a sketch on this. We'll create a circle. I'll say finish sketch. Extrude. This one as well as everything, but we don't need these. These are all the extruded parts. We don't need those. We need this one. Yeah, so direction will be one side, extent will be two object. The object will be this side of the gear. It will be joined. Okay, okay. As we're doing a static stress here, we don't need to cut it into four parts. Now again at last, again static stress. So here material, study materials will be same as the previous one. We choose cast iron, Okay, we'll go to constraints. This part is fixed. Okay. We'll go to loads. We'll add a moment. Same moment on this one. The magnitude, let it be 10,000 newtons. I'll say okay. You see, our pre-check is done. We can solve it directly. So let's solve it. I'll be solving it on the cloud. Solve one study.
A few moments later.
So our results are complete. We'll close it. We got a factor of safety of 15. That is so much. That is not required. So let's see the animation for our displacement, how it looks. So we've removed the unnecessary materials, still we can see. And we've put the same amount of load as well as the constraints. So we'll say finished results. We'll again go to the design workspace. We'll go to square gear and we'll see its properties. So you can see that its mass is 4172 grams. That would be about 4.2 kgs. So this one which we've extruded, its mass is 4.2 kgs. So now we'll roll back to the timeline. We'll see the first mass when we didn't do anything. Okay. We'll go to this properties. You can see it is 7 kgs almost. 7033 grams. That is 7 kgs. So we've cut the mass from 7 kgs to 4.1 kgs. We've almost reduced 2.9 kgs. We are applying the same load and we can see that it is safe. So this is how you reduce the weight of a component with the help of shape optimization analysis. Thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you guys have got a rough idea on how to reduce the material weight using shape optimization simulation analysis. You can follow me on social networks. The links are in the description below. I will be coming up with different types of simulation in my next videos. Do like and share if you enjoyed the video, and don't forget to subscribe.